Central Tower Ceramica Manufacturing started 2015. You know, this time I come Ghana almost 7 years. I see in the Ghana and Tower Ceramica market almost 100% import from outside. Later on, I tell our people to check Ghana the show. Ghana is a rich country, material, mineral resource is very rich. Have all to do in a tower ceramic. I plan to do in a local manufacturing. This one too is good for our Ghana. Why local not do manufacturing? This is my question. By this time I tell our management, we want to do local manufacturing for tower ceramic.
Initially, we were producing 30,000 square meter tiles a day, but currently, adding phase two to it, we produce 70,000 square meter tiles. In the production of ceramic tiles, we use most of the natural earth crust materials such as kaolin, feldspar, limestone. And luckily for us as a company, Ghana is enriched with raw materials, and about 90% we get from Ghana, around the Western region, Central region, and in the Volta region. In the production of tiles, it is important to mix the right amount of the raw material in order to get the desired tiles with its desired porosity. Number one, we have a process called barging. When we say barging, it's about separating the raw materials into the appropriate widths to be fed into the machine. After barging, we need to mix the raw materials together. Now we've mixed the raw materials well, so we move on to the second stage, which is in the ball mill. The ball mill, like its name, looks like a ball. So the raw materials are put in, and as it rolls, it mixes the properties very well. From the ball mill, where it is already mixed, the raw materials then move to the dry tower. As the name connotes, dry tower means it is going to dry the raw materials in order for us to take water and other particles from it. From the dry tower, the raw materials then move to the pressing mill. As the name connotes, pressing mill means the tiles are now formed by dry pressing. This happens when we cast the raw materials into steel cavities, which is later plunged into the machine. We then continue by using continuous heaters or dryers, which is heated through a gas methodology. So from the dry oven, we move on to the glazing machine. The glaze is fed through a disc that throws the glaze onto the tile. This makes it easy for screen printing on and under the tiles since they are wet. The tiles go through a process called firing. In a layman's point of view, we normally call it baking. Firing means the tiles must be heated intensely to achieve its desired porosity. The heating process starts gradually. During this process, the tile goes through a low temperature firing called bisque firing. This process removes the volatile tiles from the ones for the market. In order to produce quality tiles for the Ghanaian market and beyond, and also meet standard board requirements, we employ our quality control team to employ statistical process control mechanisms at every stage of the manufacturing process. This will ensure that we achieve both physical and chemical properties adequately. Currently, we have 1,500 workers in Central Ceramic Tile Company Limited. We have a little above 1,300 for Ghanaian staff, and we have a little above 100 for Chinese staff. And we run two shifts currently with one standby straight day shift. What is happening is we are now training more Ghanaians to ensure that we can form a third shift from the training. Since we don't have enough expatriates to train, we train two shifts now, and when they are ready for the job, we'll take up a third shift.
this project is a win for Ghana. One is for employment. Secondly, can do local production, no necessary to do import from outside. Can help future for economy to Ghana. This is good because this is what I do in the tower slime manufacturing in Ghana.